In this video, I'm going to teach you how to activate Elementor's breakpoints and how to configure the layout for each of these screen sizes. For those who don't know, Elementor only comes with 3 default breakpoints, and I'm going to teach you how to activate all of them from here. So, come on guys! I'm on the Innova Nutrition website, which is an institutional website with Elementor free, okay? 100% with Elementor free, which I taught you how to create on the channel. I'll leave the link on the card and in the description if you want to check it out, okay? I'll use it here as an example so I can teach you. So, as you know, you can configure the website for different screen sizes. For those who don't know, you can go here in responsive mode, and there are these 3 options: cell phone, tablet, and computer, desktop, okay? And then there are just these 3 sizes by default, but Elementor allows you to set various other screen sizes. To do this, you go to your WordPress admin panel. You go to Elementor, Settings, Experiments. It might say Features on yours too. Then you'll scroll down, and where there are breakpoints, if it says English in yours, you'll leave it active, scroll down, and save. Then you're going to reload your Elementor editor here. You're going to go into your Elementor editor here. You're going to put it in responsive mode. Yours won't be showing an extra one, okay? I'd already started setting mine up, but anyway. You'll click on Manage Breakpoints here on the gear, and this option will appear, so you can add more screen options. So there's the extra cell phone, which is the cell phone lying down. There's widescreen, which is a very large screen size, especially televisions. There's the extra tablet, which is the tablet lying down. There's a laptop, right? And here you can configure the sizes of this screen if you want to, because here is the standard size. If you think you need a different size here, depending on the size of the screen you want to configure, you can come here and configure it, and you can look here. Then you refresh, then you reload the page. And from now on, you can see various screen size options. So you click here, then there's here, see? You can see the normal phone, you can see the phone lying down. Sometimes it's normal for this little bug to happen. There was a little bug in the color, but that's normal, right? Because it was there. Oh, cell phone lying down, normal cell phone, tablet, tablet lying down, desktop, laptop, widescreen, which is those big screens, especially television. So you can configure it here for these different sizes. And so you have to pay attention to the settings. When you make a configuration according to settings and size, you can make one just for desktop, for example, one just for mobile. For example, here in this section, coming here in advanced, the padding, right, which is the size inside here, is 70. And if I put it here on mobile, it's also 70. Because it takes the default, which is the first one we set, and puts it in the other sizes, but for mobile, it's not working, see? It's making the size of this sentence too narrow. So what can I do? I can come here and leave it at 20. So as it was just a configuration I made here, Elementor allows me this feature. It's here on the cell phone, so I'm setting the padding for the cell phone. If I put it here on the desktop, the padding will remain at 70, because I've set 70 for the desktop and 20 for the mobile, okay? Now if I drag, if I delete, if I add things here, it won't stay. So, for example, let's say I have an image. I'm going to put an image here, then I'm going to put, I don't know, I'm going to pull it right here. And then here on the desktop, that image is up here. And then here on the cell phone, I thought it didn't look good at the top. I want it to be at the bottom. If I come here and drag this image down here, obviously if I come here on the computer, the image will be down here. It won't be up here on the computer. Why is that? Because I dragged it. So if I want to keep the configuration of the image up here for the computer and the image down here for the cell phone, I have to use Elementor's resources. For example, I come here in this container, I come here in layout, and I come here in reverse column, which is a configuration precisely so that you can invert the position of the elements here. This also happens if you have internal containers. I have 2 containers, 2 internal columns. If I come here to this main container and add a reverse column, the container that was below comes up. So everything comes up. Even if there were other things here, it comes up here, the way I set it up. And the other one stays down here. It's the same thing, see? I undid it, the image stays up here, and the text below. I did it, the text on top and the image on the bottom. So you use these resources. So, Spacing settings in particular are something you have to pay close attention to, because they happen a lot. It looks nice here on the desktop, and when it arrives on the cell phone, it has a big space here, precisely because the spacing wasn't configured here. What's more, if you make a type of layout that you can't change in the way you want, just with the settings, what can you do? You can hide it, for example. Let's suppose that this image here, in this way, doesn't look good on a cell phone. What can you do? Duplicate it. And then here, in this one, let's say this one, is the one I want for the computer. So I'll come here on it, come here advanced, come here responsive, and I'll leave it hidden for the other screen sizes. So I leave it hidden for tablet, for extra tablet, for extra cell phone, because I want it to appear only on the computer. So let's say I came here and made a configuration on it here. I want it to be more, black. And then the one on the cell phone won't match the layout. It's kind of gray. This is okay. This is right. There are people who say, wow, how do you remove this? There's no way. Because this is so, you know that this is an element that exists on the computer, on the other screen size. And then I do it the other way around. I come here, I come advanced, responsive, and hidden for computers, for computer screen sizes. And so when I put it here on the computer, only the image I set up appears. It only appears on the computer. When I put it here on my cell phone, only the image I set up for my cell phone appears. They're both here. If I open the editor, they both appear here. But if I close the editor, it only shows the one designed for that screen size. So you can do that. If you need something that can't be solved with size or spacing settings, you can do that. You can do this not only with images, but you can do it with containers and entire columns. So let's suppose that this way didn't work for you. Let me undo this setting here. This section didn't work for you here. You don't want it to appear. You come here to it, advanced, responsive, and hide it for mobile devices. So it won't appear here. It starts appearing from the rest of the website. If I put it here on my computer, it appears normally. So there's this feature here too, okay? So that's it, folks. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, leave a like and comment here for me. Subscribe to the channel. Cheers. See you next time. Bye.